Hello everyone, it's Lindsay, and today I'm going to jump into the newest devotional kit from Open Journey. This is Illuminated. I'll have the unboxing link down below for you guys, but I wanted to hop right in and do a page just to kind of share with you how I'm going to be working through this devotional and using some of the products in here. So I took a look at the, you know, opening part of the devotional here. Now, this is not structured, like I said, in the unboxing in like certain days or certain sections. And so I just read through and looked at some of the scriptures that she has. And I was initially going to start with this one here, Ephesians 5:13, which in the ESV translation says, "Everything exposed by the light is made visible, for what makes everything visible is light." But I went up, and usually what I do when I'm doing studies like this or diving in is I look at the scripture all around those verses. So I read like the whole passage. Sometimes I'll read the whole chapter just to kind of get the context and see what's going on. And so as I did that, I actually came up to verse 9. "But now you are light in the Lord, live as children of light, for the fruit of the light consists of all goodness, righteousness, and truth." And so this phrase, "live as children of light," really stood out to me. I did a study on this a couple years ago, and so I really wanted to focus in on this as we kick off this Illuminated devotional studies. So I will be actually journaling that verse. I'll have the specific verse linked down below for you guys instead of this Ephesians 5:13. But there is tons and tons of scripture throughout this devotional, so you can dive in and study quite a bit. And so what I've done over here is I pulled out some of the pieces from the kit that I know I'm going to want to use, some of the die cuts, the stencil, I've got the stamp set, the gold stickers, all kind of fun things like that. And then Ingrid's kits always inspire me to get a little bit messy with mixed media techniques, because she does a lot of mixed media style artwork. And so I pulled out some acrylic inks from Amsterdam. I will have everything linked down below for you guys. I've got light gold and black, because I figured I would use a little bit of this. I also brought out my Delicata gold ink and a finger dauber. I'm going to use this through the stencil. I have some gold washi tape. There are some washi strips in the kit, but I'm just going to use this thin washi here. And then I also got some like type font wood stamps and then some black alpha stickers to make my title. So let me go ahead and put you on fast forward and we will put this page together. Okay, so let's dive in and start playing with all of these goodies here. I have the stencil, and what I've done is I've picked out some of the die cuts that I want to use, and I want that ray stencil to be behind them. So I'm laying them on top of the stencil just to kind of move things around the page to figure out exactly where I want it before I start stenciling. So there's a little tip for you. I like to stage things before committing. That way I make sure it's where I want it. I'm going to add just a little bit of washi tape to the bottom of the stencil just to hold it in place. And I'm going to use that Delicata gold ink and some a finger dauber to pick up the ink and then put it through the stencil. Now with this stencil, you do want to go in a movement along the rays. So parallel to the rays, not perpendicular. Because if you scrub in the wrong direction, it's going to move those fine lines of the stencil and you're going to have some imperfect stenciling. So just a tip for you, you can see I'm just going along the lines of the rays, and that's what keeps everything in place and gets me a good impression. So I'm just rubbing this back and forth. This is a pigment ink, so it does move a little bit while it's still on the surface of the paper. This particular stencil is a little bit distressed anyways, just in the design, which I like, because then you don't have to get a perfect impression. It can be a little bit messy and imperfect, and it goes along with the style of the stencil there. So next I'm going to work on some background. I love all the background texture that Ingrid puts into her artwork. So I have this French Text Spellbinders stamp. I found it from Tuesday Mornings. I will try to find it somewhere online and link it down below for you. It comes on this really nice sturdy clear plastic, and I just leave it on that and then ink up a small area of it and just kind of smush it onto the page. And that way I'm getting just kind of a rough texture rather than like a perfect rectangular print of that stamp. And then same thing for this Tim Holtz stamp. If it's still available, I'll try to link it down below. Again, I think I got this one from Tuesday Mornings. And I just have the stamp on my fingers. I'm inking it up with some black ink and then stamping it down. By not using a block, I can get a very imperfect, rough impression. And that's what gives you that like textured background look as opposed to perfect stamping. All right, so next up is playing with these inks. I'm still trying to figure out the best way to play with these. So I tried just using the dropper and dropping it straight down onto the page. What I was wanting was this effect that Wilna Furstenberg gets when she does her mixed media artwork, and you get this kind of splash effect. These don't seem to want to do that. So I kind of played around with it and then switched up to a paintbrush and just splattered with the paintbrush. I still really need to play with these because then those big, huge drops, they take forever to dry. So I'm still kind of exploring and experimenting, but I added a little bit of black and then now I'm going in with gold. I know this seems kind of big and bold, but it actually just blends right into the background and most of this gets covered up. So little splashes of gold there. Now off camera, what I didn't film is I heat set this like crazy. It took forever to dry, but I did go ahead and dry it before I started sticking the die cuts down. I will show you at the end of the video, I'll flip the page over and you can see the backside. These inks look very pigmented, very vibrant, but they do not bleed through your Bible pages, which is awesome. So here I'm gonna start building up my title. And again, like I said, I'm working in Ephesians chapter 5 and it's verses 8 and 9. It says, "For at one time you were darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. Walk as children of light, for the fruit of light is found in all that is good and right and true." And so I just wanted to kick off this devotional study with just a reminder to myself and a prayer to the Holy Spirit to help prompt me to be a child of the light, to always shine light. That way I'm directing people to Jesus and the gift that he has of eternal life. And so I just wanted a big, bold statement and prayer as we dive into the study. So I'm going to go ahead and mix and match some Felicity Jane alpha stickers. I'll link these down below, as well as the alpha stamps that I use. And so this is going to spell out children of light. And you can see from this study, you really can get a lot, because this verse and this kind of passage wasn't even covered in this devotional study. So I really haven't technically dove into the devotional study yet. There's just so much goodness in there. So I remembered these gold stickers and pulled off just a couple of the leaves to tuck behind my die cuts, just to bring a little bit more of that shiny gold. And what you'll notice is my golds are all different shades of gold. The Delicata ink is a little bit more vintage, deep toned. The Amsterdam light gold ink is a brighter, more yellow gold. So I'm okay with that. That doesn't bug me. So mixing and matching things there. And you can see, I love the pops of gold. I love these entries from Open Journey in my Bible. I just love having her artwork and her style in my Bible. When I flip through, it's just so, so pretty and really stands out. So I'm going in with this little seal stamp and just stamping this in the bottom left-hand corner. And this is referencing, I believe, Matthew 5:14, "You are the light of the world." And I kind of second generation stamped up at the top there as well. Off camera, I went ahead and did my journaling. And as I was doing my prayer journaling, I did go ahead and mix in some of the Word Fetty stickers from the kit and then ended it with that Amen die cut. And starting to wrap things up, I'm going to create a tab, because there really aren't any tabs included in this kit, but there are these different sized prints. So this one is sized to fit in the margins of a 2-inch journaling Bible, but I don't use that. I don't use these for that. So I'm going to just use these to punch out tabs. So I use that We Are Memory Keepers tab punch, and then I can go ahead and stick that on the top. All of that will be linked in the description box down below for you guys. I'm going to layer a little bit of gold washi over the top of that, and then I'll use another Word Fetty sticker. I did trim down some of the white space on these just so that it would fit on the tab a little bit better, just indicating that this is from the Illuminated Devotional. And that is going to be it for the entry today. So here's a look at the backside. There is a little bit of shadowing, but no bleed through. So if you have any questions or comments, be sure to leave those down below. Check out the description box for links to everything. Definitely go check out this kit. It's a good one, guys. Join in with us. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to my channel if you're not already subscribed. And until next time, thank you so much. Bye-bye.